Afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Have you enjoyed lunch?
Yes.
Yes.
What taste of Thai?
Delicious.
Very delicious. I had two plates.
Oh, wow.
Okay, when
I see everyone have lunch, you seem to be more active for the class in the afternoon. Okay. Are you ready to go to the lesson?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I will study. Today, I want to talk about the topic conditions. Have you ever heard this word before?
Impact bones mean the spread bone,
yes.
And have a head is that chondroid bone, you know?
Okay. That's right. That's a good answer. Conditioned means cartilage. I'm sure you know two fish species.
Tilapia.
Okay. The above is tilapia species and below is shark. Anyone can tell me about how different are two species?
Size of fish.
What is the difference?
Fresh fish and marine fish.
Some shark can live in fresh water fish. Can live in fresh water. Yes. Which one?
Bone.
Okay, skin. What's skin? Which skin?
Scale.
Shark is a
scale of fish. Shark have scale. Have scale. To protect them. Have scale. Yes, sir. Tell me. Which one is different?
Bone. Shark is cutting
it.
Yeah.
Any else?
When
you see action for the external, when we saw in the external body, external structure, what is the difference you can see and you can tell me?
The gills.
Gill. The above one has one gill cover. Gill opening. And shark has
spine.
I would like to show you about the tail. Tail fin. What happened? different or same?
Different.
When you cross, the line along the body, tilapia has similar to symmetry, chordotin.
But
chak, not the same symmetry. Okay, everyone seem have a knowledge before listening to class about quantities to make you better understand. I will get you in the outline of this class. The first, I will start with definition of quantities. Second, I will move on characteristics of quantities. And finally, I will go to the classification of quantities. Okay, let's go to the first part of the quantities. Quantities is origin from Greek. It's combined two words, chrons and itis. Chron means cartilage, and itis means fish. When I combine the two words together, chron itis means a class of fish that include with a fish that has cartilage bone. If you know about cartilage, what is cartilage different from bone? If anyone know?
Is it soft?
Mm-hmm. Cartilage is soft.
No calcium inside.
Yes. Yes. Good.
And flexible.
Yes. Yes. As you know, bone has blood vessel in all bone. And blood vessel can make bone grow and to repair them. We have protein, mineral can make bone is harder, but cartilage not. Cartilage has a connective tissue that's composed with fiber, connective tissue fiber, or elastin fiber. Yes, so the density of cartilage bone is half normal of bone. Okay. And then we go to the characteristic of cartilage. The fish in this class has many features that differ from bony fish. The first one, the fish in class quantities, or we can use cartilage fish. Cartilage fish has cartilaginous skeleton, as you know. Cartilage is from so flexible, and due to proper for this fish to live in the deep marine. Okay, this picture show the characteristic of cartilage. The above one is pectoral fin. In the left side, pectoral fin together, and the right picture is dorsal fin. You see, this cartilage doesn't like the spine, or spina of common fish. This picture shows cartilage. Which one is cartilage? Which one cartilage?
The bottom left side.
Okay. For the top picture.
Yes.
This cartilage. This one cartilage. Yes. Cartilage of shark. Cartilage of ray.
Ray.
This bony fish, skeleton bone. The second feature of characteristic of cartilaginous fish is internal fertilization. As you know, the common fish has internal fertilization. But the fertilization in form internal fertilization is the spectrolite, only cartilaginous fish. In the reproduction of this fish, the male fish has organ that we call Casper is an intermittent organ to use when they are in mating. Yes, that's shark mating. Yes.
Only
shark or ray. Yeah. This cartilage fish have yes, internal fertilization. Ray, shark, and hybrid has. Yes. Okay, as you know, when the fertilization process is begin, that has many of fish have oviparous. That's a technical term to explain about what is happening. Oviparous means to the female lay eggs external and the eggs grow out. But shark has both oviparous and ovoviviparous pattern. Ovoviviparous means to the young bird grow in the mother. When they grow up, they can move out of mother. Maybe like kangaroo, but not the same way to the mammal. Mammal has placenta. Yes. Mammal has uterus, but this fish have no uterus. The next feature of the characteristic of this fish is heterocercal tail. As I mentioned in the early, when I cross along the body shape, common fish has the symmetry of circle of caudal fin, but shark or cardiac fish, when we cross, they're not symmetry. The upper lobe seem to larger than the lower. That's the special feature of this fish. The next, we go to Plakhoi scale. Cardiac fish has many tiny scales. If we don't touch the skin of this fish, we can't know he has scale or scaling. If we don't touch, we don't know. But this fish has scale. Now when I attend the picture from the left, we can see there are many, many tiny scales. When expanding, you saw this is the special scale of this fish. This picture shows you the structure of Plakhoi scale. What does it look like? Glass airplane?
Wow.
Outside the skin, and the light green is buried in the skin. The below picture, I show you other side. You can see. This is a reason for when we use shark olive or food, it hard to eliminate the skill. That's the reason that we rarely bring this fish to meal food. It hard to remove skill from the fish. The fifth feature of the characteristics is the absence of swim bladder. Do you know swim bladder? Swim bladder or gas bladder or air bladder? It means the organ that fill with air or gas inside. This organ make fish to control or make them buoyancy or is feel to have an upward force. Upward force to bring them to the surface or anywhere of the water. But shark has no swim better. Anyone can tell me why? Why the shark or cartilage fish has no bladder? Anyone can tell me? Okay. I will show you this the next picture. You see, in the ocean soil, shark or cartilage fish can live everywhere. Surface, middle, or the bottom. This fish can live. They can move from the deep area to the middle of the water and to the surface of the water. They can move with us. Yes. Swim better means organ with fill of air or gas
in
this.
I
will show you about the bubble.
Bubble.
You know the bubble? Air inside.
Yes.
Yes. And they are same way. Yes. Okay, sorry. Okay. This is a reason for this fish. If they have swim better, what happened when they move from the bottom to the middle to the surface of the water in us? What happened?
They explode.
Yes. 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 And go to the throat. This picture shows the phenomenon of the approach of air bladder of our swim bladder.
That means it's usually to live in the surface of water, mm-hmm. or the middle, usually to live.
It means to approach when the fish move in the past. When it change the level that there is to the each level. Yes. The next picture is cartilage like fish has spiral intestine. You know spiral intestine. It's specific for this fish. It means the wall of the intestine has a helix to increase the ability of absorption. And finally picture of this fish. You can see shark in the left or shark in the right. There are different in the opening. The left one has 7 and the right one is 5.
picture in the right side. These are rain. Rain has five opening. Do you have any question about the characteristic of this fish? Anyone have a question?
About the oviplus, why have about the oviplus, but not viviplus. We have a oviplus, oviplus, and oviplus.
Oviplus means when it was young as it has yolk sac within larva. Yolk sac within larva of this fish. Ovo means to ovo or yolk. Ovo. But vivi is a vivi or live.
Is that it already?
Yes.
But in the chat and about the ray, can lay about the young,
yes.
Young ray and young chat, why we don't call Vivi Palace?
Vivi
Palace is new, when we lay about the young lady or anything, can move, can eat anything.
Oh no, because of the position of this fish is internal, but they lay eggs. They lay eggs in internal, and we go back to the fertilization. There are internal fertilization.
Yes.
Okay. Male
sperm.
Sperm to
fertilize the egg.
Internal. Yes. When the live egg, each egg is ripe, the sperm will go to the fertilizer and go in mountain. But when the development happen, they will use yolk or food for egg to development. They use yolk.
When I learned about the biology, you know, for a long time,
yes.
About the viviplus is mean when animal or anything can lay about the larvae or baby, we call viviplus. And ovo viviplus is mean about when fertilized and lay the egg. The egg has a baby inside, same in a snake. Pit viper snake or anything, when let the egg come out, it's not an incubator, it can hatching about the larvae from the egg. And oviplus is mean about lay the egg. We call oviplus, ovoviplus, and viviplus.
Ovo combined with.
Okay.
Ovo or yolk.
Yes,
up to Vivi or Vivi or yes. Okay, I
That's fine.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. I will go to the classification of Cardiacna fish. Cardiacna fish has divided into two subclass, Elasmobranchii and Holocephala. Common name of this fish in Elasmobranchii is Elasmobranch. And the other one is Hypera in Holocephala. These two books are different in the number of gills. Shark has 5 to 7 gills, but Pamela only one has only one. because more branch eye will be subdivided into two groups, sharp and ray and scale. Sharp and ray and scale, you separate from the location of gill opening. Sharp has gill opening is on the both side of the body, on both side. But scale and ray has usually beneath the mouth, on the ventral of the body. And commonly, we can separate sharp from skate or race. If we look at the body shape, sharp has streamlined, and they are flattened body. Ray and scale will separate in three orders. Latiformes, pisciformes, and probiformes. We can separate by the difference of petrophin you see in the first picture. Petrophin are large. The next one is look like shark, okay? But body is flattened. The final one is we know as electric ray. This fish in this group can produce electricity. We go to the classification of shark. We can divide the group of shark into S orders. I'll show you in the picture. We can classify the shark with the important feature. Exact high performance or SL. We can classify them separate. Did you know Hammer Shark?
Hammer Shark. Yeah.
This fish is, what is the, what is the most interesting of this species?
His eyes
at the end of the head. Not the same fish. And some other has the special line of nictitating membrane. Nictitating membrane means the eyelid. When shark want to close the eye to protect from the dust on the bottom, they can move eyes to close.
Yes.
And two last order of shark.
Mackerel.
Due to the body shape. Due to the body shape. And we go to the last the last slide, this fish or cartilaginous fish in surpass polo supply, or the common name of this fish, chimera. Chimera. Chimera is a cartilaginous fish that look like the bony fish because they have only one gill opening. But the main characteristic is like the other species like shark or squid or ray, only gill opening that look like bony fish. Do you have any question? Let's bring me to, before we meet to the end of the presentation. If you have no more question, I have. Anyone can tell me what is the meaning of polyrictis?
Can I say
soft bone fish? Soft bone fish, yes, yes, right. Anyone can explain? Fruit of fish, okay?
Fish.
Really? Chakra, and space group. And chimera. Go to the next question.
Alright, bring it on. Next question.
How do you tell the gender of shark or ray or chimera? What can I classify? This one is male, this one is female.
Casper,
yes, that's right. You are a good student.
Casper.
Casper
is not
moved
in the body.
Okay. Male use Casper to listen in the opening of female.
When the female wants to use this, it can move out, and then use the cat to move in. Yes. The next question. This tailfin is a characteristic of cartilaginous fish. Which one? One, two, or three?
One.
That's right, that's the correct answer. Number two, we call homo circle. Homo means equal. And in the three picture, this tail called hypo circle. Hypo circle means the upper lobe is larger than the upper. The lower is larger than upper. This tail in the. Do you know flying fish?
Yes.
Flying fish.
Yes, flying fish.
Yes.
Excuse me, teacher. I want to know what.
The last question.
มันมีผลต่อการไม่น้ำยังไง
ว่ายน้ำ
ช่วงแบบทางเงี้ยค่ะมันมีผลต่อการไม่น้ำมีผลต่อการถูก
Can you explain
when they are swimming, when they are doing swimming, so this is effect.
When the fish want to swim, they use cervical tail and body, the muscle of the body, they use in the boat. Column fin used to control the direction of the movement, control the direction. But the kayaking fish is special in column tail. You can see cartilage bone is upward to the top. This make the tail is more strong. And they can use for to make a pause to go forward.
Faster?
Yes, combined with body shape of this fish as well.
Okay, thank you very much.
Is it finished?
Okay, anyone have any question? If you know more question, I thank you for your attention. Thank you very much.